What you've been waiting for. It's about to happen. You guys are beautiful. Thank you for being here. I'm going to introduce some of our elected and special guests who are here. Yes, I'll pause it. Hold on. Judge Andy Brown. Senator Sarah Eckhart. Wendy Davis. Railroad Commission candidate Luke Warford. Representative Celia Israel. Lulu Flores running for HD 51 here in Travis County. Constable George Morales. And Judge Israel Garcia from the Harris County, he's a Harris County JP. And now I'm going to pause for a second. And now we're ready. I'm Donna Howard. I'm state representative here in Travis County, and I am the chair of the Women's Health Caucus at the legislature, where, along with Wendy Davis when she was in the Senate, we have been fighting this bullshit for years. I came of age before Roe v. Wade. Many of you here, it looks like, have known nothing but the protection of Roe v. Wade. I came of age before Roe v. Wade. I know what it was like when women did not have autonomy over their own bodies, able to make their own choices, be able to pursue education and employment opportunities, and be equal participants in society. Abbott and the Republican-controlled legislature have totally banned abortion in Texas without even an exception for rape and incest and for women who have complications in their pregnancy. In fact, the doctors are telling us we have to wait for women to start dying before we can intervene and save their lives. And these forced pregnancies are occurring in a state that has one of the highest maternal mortality rates in the country and in the developed world. So I'm sure you heard last night when Abbott was asked, what alternative is there for those who have been sexually assaulted if they can't get an abortion? Baby supplies! You can't make this shit up. So, we are going to change what's happening at the legislature. And because redistricting and gerrymandering make it very difficult to totally change the legislature, let me tell you, we still can affect change because guess what? The governor of the state of Texas has the veto power. So despite the legislature, we can still make headway here because we can elect a governor who will veto this shit. Beto O'Rourke is a fighter for Texas women. He will fight to ensure that every woman in this state has the power to make decisions herself about her own body, about her own health care, and about her own future. We're not going back. And Beto O'Rourke is the path forward. So let me present to you the next governor of the great state of Texas, Beto O'Rourke.
All right, Austin.
Thank you all for being here. Thank you for being here.
How's everybody feeling? It is so good to be here with you on one of the most beautiful days ever created, under this glorious sky with all these wonderful people who are around us. You know, all of that chaos and cruelty and confusion that is the product of this current governor, that is not reflected in the faces that I see here right now. Someone who wants us to hate each other or be scared of one another based on our differences instead of coming together to do the big things in Texas today, that's not us. We are the ones who are going to do the big things that we have been waiting to do for far too long, but have been divided and kept from doing so because we have people in power who are more interested in their power than the people that they're supposed to serve. Am I right? I want to thank Donna Howard, all these amazing VIPs and public servants, extraordinary leaders, other people who are on the ticket right now. Ladies, up and down the ballot. Men, you as well. We've got Luke Warford, our railroad commissioner candidate, who's right over here. Jay Clayburgh, who's running for land commissioner. Susan Hayes, agriculture commissioner. Janet Dudding for comptroller. I know comptroller sounds boring, but can I get it? Janet Dudding for comptroller. Yeah. Mike Collier for lieutenant governor. Rochelle Garza, your next attorney general. And are you ready to win this one for governor? I tell you what, I feel it today more than I ever have before. Almost a year on the road. No county or community too small, too rural, too Republican represented for us to show up. No community too big, too blue, too urban for us to listen and learn from those that we want to serve and represent. And I'll tell you what, the things that we're talking about in this campaign, bringing people together, getting beyond the division and the hatred and the polarization, it is working everywhere that we go. Almost every town hall that we've held, we invite anyone to ask any question. And we say, it does not matter. No me importa. If you're a Republican, you're in the right place. Democrats, you're welcome as well. Independents, we're glad that you came out. All of you matter to us in our Texas, right? And even those who come out to oppose us and protest our presence, we invite them in too. They're just as important as anyone else. And I'll tell you what, it's starting to work. Listening to, finding the common ground amongst one another. We were in Bowie. Anybody from Bowie in Montague County? Anyone heard of it? There you go. This protester who came in, because we invited her in, wouldn't relinquish her Abbott sign. Listened to everything that we had to say about expanding Medicaid and fully funding our schools and ensuring that the best jobs in America are created right here in Texas. And we give her the microphone. And she says, you know what? I kind of agree with what you have to say. I'm a retired principal. And this underfunding of our educators, it's really hitting home here in Montague. We can't find enough teachers to bring them on the rolls. By the end of that conversation, she and I are agreeing with one another. We're shaking hands. We might have even won her vote. And then here's the kicker. The following week, the Greg Abbott campaign emails all of their supporters around the state of Texas. And they say, listen, it's fine if you want to protest Beto's visit to your community, but whatever you do, do not go inside and listen to what he has to say, because we're losing too many of you. These visits, going everywhere for everyone, writing nobody off, taking no one for granted, our ability to go toe-to-toe with Greg Abbott in that debate on Friday night. Did you all see it? Did we make the case that we need change? I feel pretty good, and I felt pretty good then. I felt good all along, but never better than I do today, because, ladies and gentlemen, I know that we are going to win this election on November 8th. We're going to win because we're fighting for every woman to make her own decisions about her own body, her own future, her own health care. We're going to win Because we prioritize the lives of our kids over the interests of the NRA, any politician, any political consideration whatsoever. We're going to have the backs of every school teacher, counselor, librarian, support staff, bus driver, those who make public ed possible. Pay them enough so they don't have to work a second or a third job. Give those retired teachers a cost of living adjustment. They haven't had one in 18 years. Cancel the damn STAR test so you can focus on those kids in front of you. This is the Texas agenda. We're going to do common sense, bipartisan things. What about returning $10 billion of your federal income taxes to Texas to connect more people with health care, more mental health care, so it's no longer our county jails doing the job? It's psychiatrists and psychologists and therapists. And listen, in honor of the man who will follow me on this stage, when we win, we are going to legalize marijuana in the state of Texas. And given the fact that Texans of all races, all ethnicities, all backgrounds use marijuana at roughly the same rate, but only some, particularly black and brown Texans, disproportionately are arrested, stopped, frisked, incarcerated, upon release, forced to check a box on every employment application form going forward, we will expunge the arrest records of anybody caught in possession of a substance that's already legal in most of the rest of the country. You all with me? And in a state where in March, during our primary elections, 13% of the mail-in ballots cast were rejected or returned. 13 out of 100 votes cast never made it to the candidate of their choice. We don't know if that's a Republican or a Democrat, but in a democracy, that doesn't matter. 95-year-old World War II veteran, true story, has his ballot by mail rejected not once, but three times. This guy in World War II was willing to give his life to defend our democracy, to fight fascism half a world away. Tell me there is someone who has better earned the right to vote than that guy. We got to make sure that when we win, we restore right to vote for everyone in the state of Texas. That means no more gerrymandering where members of Congress choose their voters, independent redistricting commissions where you choose the boundaries, automatic online and same-day voter registration. And for those who are struggling to take some time off from work or to school to cast your ballot, how about this? We replace Confederate Heroes Day as a state holiday with Election Day as a state holiday. You all with me on this? Here's another way that I know we're going to win. And I saw it up close and personal on Friday night. And that is the fact that we are running against the worst governor in the United States of America today, Greg Abbott. Let me give it to you by the numbers. 1 month ago, his most extreme abortion ban, no exception for rape, no exception for incest. It begins at conception in the maternal mortality epicenter of the United States, three times as deadly for black women. 1 month ago, that law went into effect. But here's the thing. Not only can we overcome this, we've overcome a challenge like this before against much longer odds. 50 years ago, abortion was just as illegal in the state of Texas as it is today. But no one from outside of this state rode to the rescue of the women of Texas. In fact, it was the women of Texas who rode to the rescue of the rest of this country. Jane Roe, Sarah Weddington, Linda Coffey, three Texas women prevailed upon an all-male United States Supreme Court to win Roe versus Wade, protection for the right to make your own decisions without any government interference. And listen, here's my bet. If it was the women of Texas who did it 50 years ago, it will be the women of Texas who do it again today. We are so lucky right now to be joined by some of the family members of Jackie Casares. an extraordinarily beautiful, gifted, talented young girl whose life was taken from us on the 24th of May, 2022, along with 18 of her classmates at Robb Elementary in Uvalde, Texas. Two teachers who had already given the best years of their lives to those kids day in and day out, literally gave their lives to try to keep them alive when someone armed with a weapon of war designed to take an enemy soldier down at 500 yards, penetrate a steel helmet, walked into that classroom not 5 feet from those kids with nothing on their head but a baseball cap. They were absolutely defenseless against him, but they're absolutely defenseless against a governor who refuses to lift a finger to prioritize their lives. 19 weeks and nothing has been done to prevent this from happening to any other child in any other school, in any other community in Texas. Here's what we have to do. After we win this election, we must come around the table, prioritize those lives, decide, look, we're Texans. We're going to defend the Second Amendment, but we're going to better protect the lives of our children, those teachers, the people in our community, in a state where gun violence today is the leading cause of death for children and teenagers. We know that we can do better. And though this may be Greg Abbott's fault thus far, if we fail to change it, all of us are culpable. And if you're like me, you fear the judgment of your kids more than anything else. We cannot be found wanting. This is what we're going to do. Universal background checks for anyone who wants to buy any firearm in the state of Texas. A red flag law so that if you have that firearm and you're threatening to use it against somebody else, we can intervene before it is too late. And at a minimum, let's raise the age of purchase to 21 for an AR-15 or an AK-47. I'm with you. But on this much, there is common ground. And again, listening to Republicans, gun owners, Democrats, non-gun owners, just people in the state of Texas, they know that we can get this done. And ladies and gentlemen, we are going to get this done. Two more numbers for you. 19 months ago, almost to the day, you were freezing in your apartments and in your homes. Here in the energy capital of the world, the guy in power could not keep the power flowing to the people that he purportedly served. In fact, while rolling blackouts were taking place across the state of Texas, he ordered the price of electricity sold at its highest allowable rate. Gas, which powers those turbines, started trading at 200 times what it had sold for the day before. His best friends and top campaign contributors literally made billions of dollars while you were freezing in your home. 700 of our fellow Texans lost their lives, froze to death in their beds, unable to pile enough blankets atop their bodies, burned up when their parents set fire to their furniture trying to keep their kids warm, died of carbon monoxide poisoning in their garages. And do you think this governor has called a single one of those families to apologize for what he's done? Do you think he's even bothered to fix the grid? All he has done is literally pass the buck. You are now paying $45 more per month on your utility bills because of Greg Abbott. That is the Abbott tax in Texas. But we've got an answer to that. One, after we win this election, we winterize and weatherize every part of the grid. Two, we connect ERCOT, our grid, with the national grid so we can draw down power when we need it. And three, for those who took $11 billion from us in our moment of need, when we were suffering and we were dying, we are going to take those bastards to court and get every single penny back for the people of Texas. We're going to bring down your utility bills as a result. Last number that I want to give you, and that is the number 8. That's how many years this guy, Greg Abbott, has been serving in the highest position of public trust in this state. For those of you who watched or listened to the debate on Friday night, he would blame anybody but himself. The problems in our state, if you were to listen to him, are all Joe Biden's fault. Or this guy, even though I have not been governor for any years over the last 8 years, If you think about the challenges that we have in Texas right now, if you're feeling pain at this moment, I want you to think about Greg Abbott, the 8 years that he's had in order to make things better. And I want you to remember that when he seeks to scare you about all of us. Now, he's going to talk about violent crime in the state of Texas. He's going to talk about funding law enforcement in our communities. Hear me right now. After 8 years, homicides are up in this state 50%. They're up 50% because when police officers and sheriff's deputies begged him not to sign permitless carry into law, which allows anyone to carry a gun in public without a background check, any vetting, any training whatsoever, he turned his back on them and looked right at the NRA and signed that into law. Now today, homicides up 50%. More police officers shot down in this state than any other in the union. And as I mentioned, gun violence, the leading cause of death for children and teenagers. The governor, when he was signing his total abortion ban and was asked by a reporter what he was going to do about the fact that there was no exception for rape, infamously replied, "We are going to eliminate rape in the state of Texas." Because of Greg Abbott, more rapes have been committed in the state of Texas than in any other state. Because under his leadership, there are 3,000 untested rape kits at DPS headquarters right here in Austin, Texas. Because under Greg Abbott, a rapist has more rights than does his victim. In fact, he can sue that victim's family if they assist her in trying to get an abortion and collect a $10,000 bounty. He has made us less safe. He's given criminals, especially rapists, more free rein in this state and has dropped the ability to bring them to justice by half under his watch. I tell you what, we win this election, and not only will we fully fund law enforcement, we'll fully fund their training so they treat every single one of us equally under the law, regardless of the differences between us. And for those who abuse the public trust and that life and death power that they hold over us, we will hold them accountable, and there will be justice for the people of Texas. That increases trust, it improves public safety, and it improves security. Last thing that I want to tell you, because it's the first thing that he's going to try to scare you about. He's the master of deflection and distraction and lies. You know, ask him why he can't keep the lights on, or why teachers are leaving the profession by the thousands in the state of Texas, or why CPS is the worst-run foster care program in the United States of America today. And he'll try to get you scared about transgender kids or critical race theory in our classrooms. Who knew that a graduate-level course was being taught in the first and second grade in the state of Texas? Nobody knew, because it is not. But the thing that he's going to try to get you most scared about is the border. And the people that he wants you to be afraid of more than anyone else are those who seek to come here to work, to join family, to seek asylum, because to return to their countries of origin might very well mean certain death for them or for their children. Now, these stunts of busing migrants to Washington, D.C., Chicago, New York, building 1.5 miles, literally, of border wall. 1.5 miles. It is more of an art installation than it is a security device in the state of Texas. That's not making us safer. But I'll tell you what. This rhetoric describing human beings as an invasion, asking Texans to defend ourselves, and he literally said this, take matters into our own hands. We experienced the consequence of that in El Paso on the 3rd of August, 2019. Somebody listening to Greg Abbott and to the former president who thought there was an invasion coming to this country bought a weapon of war, drove it 650 miles to my hometown, posted online before he walked into that Walmart that he had come to repel the invasion of Hispanics who were coming to take over this state, and murdered 23 people in a city that doesn't lose 20 people over the course of an entire year. In fact, El Paso, one of, if not the safest cities in America, not despite, but because we are a city of immigrants and we find a way to come together and do right by and for one another. We saw it again this last week Someone was shot and killed who had come into this country seemingly randomly by someone here who may have been fueled by the same hateful rhetoric. Not only is what he's doing not making us any safer, it's literally costing the lives of our fellow human beings. And look, you may or may not already feel this way, but let me invoke your powers of empathy. No one travels 2,000 miles to this country on foot, atop a train known as the Beast or La Bestia for kicks. No one climbs into the back of a tractor trailer with 52 other people on a hot Texas summer day with their kids to steal your job or take your place in society or get the red carpet treatment from this country. They do so because it might be the only way to save their lives and to save the lives of their kids. John Lewis, with whom I was lucky enough to serve in Congress, had this saying. He said, look, we all got here in a different ship at a different time, but today we find ourselves in the same boat. Your family may have come here 15,000 years ago, and we should remember that we're standing on indigenous native land right now, right? Your family may have been kidnapped in Africa, brought here against their will and in bondage, forced to build the wealth, the success of this state without ever partaking in any of the benefit. Your family, like mine, may have come here in the 19th century, fleeing famine in Ireland. A million lives were claimed in that country. The O'Rourkes came to the one place on the planet that would take them in. Those coming today from Haiti and El Salvador and Honduras and the world over are part of this same tradition that has made this country great in the first place. All I ask of us is that we meet this opportunity with some common sense and some common values. We say, look, if you want to come to this country, follow our laws. But on our end, we're going to make sure that our laws follow our values, our interests, and our needs. There will be a safe, legal, orderly path for anyone who wants to come here and do better for themselves and, by extension, do better for all of us. Those who want to join family, I want to be with my family. Those who want to work, who doesn't want to work? Those who want to save the lives of their kids, there's nothing more human or Texas than that. We're going to be able to get this done. But what it's going to take is all of us doing all we can with what we have, where we are. I appeal to you, over these next 37 days, join us in this campaign. Knock on doors, make phone calls, join our letter writing campaign, sign up with one of these volunteers wearing the yellow reflective vest. They're all around us in this crowd. They're holding up the clipboards right now. I promise you, those very Texans who are the focus of this governor's suppression and intimidation efforts, the people who have been intentionally drawn out, I will put you on their doors. You will meet them face to face, human to human, eyeball to eyeball. That connection, more than anything else that we can do, will bring them into this next election. And the very people who were written off will provide the margin of victory when we win this on election night. You all with me? And listen, there's one more super important reason that gives me confidence that we are going to win this election. And that is because we have Willie Nelson with us right now. Y'all ready for Willie? Here he comes. Thank you, Austin, Texas, for coming out. Welcome, Willie, Micah, and Kevin. Here we go.
Whiskey River, take my mind. Don't let her memory torture me. Whiskey River, don't run dry. river take my mind. Don't let her memory torture me. Whiskey River, don't run. You're all I got, take care of me. Whiskey River, bathed my memory at night in the wetness of his soul, feeling the amber current flowing from my mind, and warm and empty heart you left so cold. Whiskey River, take my mind, don't let her memory torture me. Whiskey River, don't run dry. All I got, take care of me. Whiskey River, take my mind. Don't let her memory torture me. Whiskey River, don't run dry. You're all I got, take care of me. If you go in with a mill, the bridge you always stay out at the bottom of the hill. Big creeks up and the little creeks level. Plow my corn with a double shovel. You gotta stay all night.
Stay a little longer.
Dance all night.
Dance a little longer.
Pull off your coat.
Throw it in the corner. Don't see
why you don't stay a little longer. You ought to see my blue-eyed Sally. Lives away down on Shinboard Alley. And the number on the gate and the number on the door. The next house over is a grocery store. Stay all night.
Stay a little longer.
Dance all night.
A little longer.
Pull off your coat.
Throw it in the
corner. Don't see why you don't steal a lover. Well, you ought to see my blue eyes, Sally. Just waiting out on Shinboard Alley and the number on the gate. Number on the door. Next house over is a grocery store. You gotta stay all day.
Stay a little longer.
Dance all day.
Dance a little longer.
Pull off your coat.
Throw it in the corner. Don't see why you don't
stay a little longer. Says stay all day.
Stay a little longer.
Dance all day.
Dance a little longer.
And pull off your coat.
Throw it in the corner. Don't see why you don't stay a little longer.
I don't see why you don't stay a little longer. Them babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars, drive them old trucks, make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama! They'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys ain't easy to love and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds and gold. Long star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. And if you don't understand him and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away. Mama! Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama! they'll never stay home, and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys like smoky old pool rooms and clear mountain mornings, little warm puppies and children and girls of the night. Them that don't know it won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take him. He ain't wrong, he's just different, but his pride won't let him do things to make you think he's right. Mama! Guitars and drive them old trucks. Make them be doctors and lawyers. Mama! They'll never stay home, and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Thank you very much. Y'all can help me on this one. The stars at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of things. The prairie sky is wide and high, deep in the heart of things. The sage in blue is like perfume, deep in the heart of things. Reminds me of the one I love, deep in the heart of Texas. Trail deep in the heart of Texas. The rabbits rush around the brush, deep in the heart of Texas. The stars at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of Texas. The prairie sky is wide and high, deep in the heart of Texas. The sage in bloom is like perfume, deep in the heart of Texas. Reminds me of the one I love, deep in the heart of Texas. Thank you very much. I'd like to do this song for our next governor. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, look them in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. Won't see no sad and teary eye when I get my wings and it's my time to fly.
Time to fly.
Just call my friends and tell them there's a party, come on by. And then
roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Me out and build a roaring fire.
Roaring fire!
Throw me in the flames for about an hour.
About an hour!
Take me out and twist me up and point me toward the sky. Now just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Everybody sing. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, look out in the eyes. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just
roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Right. Big finish. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. Thank you very much. On the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. And I can't wait to get on the road, everybody say. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends. And the world keeps turning our way, and our way. I can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again, big pity. I can't wait to get on the road again. Thank you. All right, thank you very much. Y'all help us sing. This is a very important song. If you don't like who's in there, vote them out. If you don't like who's in there, vote them out. That's what election day is all about. The biggest gun we've got is called the ballot box. And if you don't like who's in there, vote them out. Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
And when they're gone, we'll sing and dance and shout. We'll run some new ones in, then we'll start the show again. And if you don't like who's in there, vote them out. Well, if it's a bunch of clowns you voted in, election day is coming round again. If you don't like it now, you can change it anyhow. And if you don't like who's in there, vote. Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
And when they're gone, we'll sing and dance and shout. We'll run old Beto in, and we'll start the show again. And if you don't like who's in there, vote them out. One more time. Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
Vote them out.
And when they're gone, we'll sing and dance and shout. We'll bring some new ones in. And we'll start the show again. And if you don't like who's in there, vote them out. Big finish. If you don't like who's in there, vote them out. Thank y'all very much. It's a good day for Texas. Thank y'all. To you folks there, the parents who've gone through some incredible sad times, remember that it's not something you get over, but it's something you will get through. Thank you.